वेलकम एवरीवन. सो टुडे आई विल बी सॉल्विंग वन मोर प्रॉब्लम ऑन स्क्वायर पिरामिड व्हिच इज रेस्टिंग ऑन वन ऑफ इट्स कॉर्नर. सो हियर आल्सो द एक्सिस इज इंक्लाइंड टू एचपी एंड बीपी. सो इट इज अ प्रॉब्लम ऑन अपेरेंट एंगल बीटा. ओनली द चेंज इज द गिवन पोजीशन इज रेस्टिंग ऑन वन ऑफ इट्स कॉर्नर्स. So previous problem we were solving when it was resting on one of its edge. So now I explained you before also how does it look when it is resting on one of its corner. So this is our HP and BP. So if it is resting on one of its corner, we keep one of the corner towards our right so that you will be having a other corner exactly opposite to it. Okay. So it is resting on one of its corner. You have to show the corner here. If it is resting on one of its edge, then we'll keep the edge to our right so that you'll be getting the opposite edge in the other way. Since it is resting on one of its corner, so this will be the position. How does it look? So when the given problem is resting on one of its corner such that the base edges will be equally inclined to BP. So these are the edges of the base which are equally inclined to HP. So the angle will be equally inclined to both the sides if you take here or if you take here. So this is how you have to fix the position. So when it is resting in one of its corner, you'll be having two corners deadly opposite to each other. So when you view from the top, you will get the top view like an rhombus, right? It won't be a regular square, it will be an inclined square, or you can call it looks like an rhombus. And you will be having the center O. At the top will be visible, the center of the bottom surface will not be visible. So I'll put it in the bracket. Similarly, when you view from the front, you will take the projection of this corner, the projection of this corner, and the projection from the longer edge to the vertical plane, and also the projection from the apex. So it will just look like a triangle because the pyramid is bounded by the triangular surfaces. You have an axis here from the apex to the bottom of the square prism, but that axis is overlapped by the longer edge over here, and hence we cannot show the axis line in the front view. Instead of that, we'll be showing a continuous visible line of this longer edge, because when you view from the front, this edge will be visible. Due to the edge visibility, the axis line which is inside will not be visible, it will be overlapped. So you'll have a rhombus or an inclined square as a top view, and you will be having a rectangular surface as our front view, where the axis will be replaced by the longer edge in our front view. So first we will draw an inclined square when you view from the top. Okay, so how does it look? You should first draw an XY line, and since it is resting on one of its corner, you should have the corner, not the vertical edge. So you will fix one of the corner towards our right. For that, you should have an inclined square like this. How you draw? First, for a reference plane, just draw a horizontal line. Fix some particular point. So from there, just take 45 degree. So this side will be 45, and this side also will be 45 degrees. So both will be exactly 45. So after that, you will measure the distance 35 mm. So you keep one end of the compass here and you just cut an arc for 35 mm. And similarly, you'll keep one end of the compass here and you just cut an arc for 35 mm. So you got the two sides. Again, you need to do the rest two parts. So how you will do it? For that, you should draw a parallel line here to this edge, such that this will be 90 degree. So once you draw a parallel line to this edge, you again measure 35 mm, because the side given is 35 mm. You just cut an arc. It meets somewhere. So from there, you kindly join this. So you constructed an inclined square, which is our true shape of the top view, right? So always for solid, we should connect and identify the center. So you will join the diagonal and identify the center. No need to show this 45 degree and all. You can just erase. For your reference, I just told you how to construct it. So when you view from the top, the top center will be visible, bottom center will not be visible. So top center you will write outside the bracket, and bottom center you will write it as O1. And a review from the top, all the corners of the base will be visible. So you can write that as A, B, C and D. So our true shape of the top view is over. Kindly show the dimension for any one of the edge as 35 mm. Okay, so please show it neatly. So then we will take the projection above. So you see that you take the projection from each corner. So here you have the axis, but the axis is replaced by one more edge. And hence we can't show the axis line here. It will be a continuous line. So what is the height? It is 60 mm. So show this longer edge as per the height of the axis. So measure 60 mm, keep one end of the compass here and cut an arc. It will meet at some common point. In a pyramid, always it is joined to a common point, which we call it as apex. So this is our O1. At 60 degree, and later you will join this corner to our apex and also this corner. So we got our front view. So when the observer views from here, A will be visible. So when it comes to front view, it will be A dash. So when the observer views from here, B and D will be visible. So B will be visible, D will be hidden. So we will write B dash outside the bracket and D dash within the bracket. Along with that you have a center O1. It will not be visible because you have one more curve, longer edge overlapping. So you will write O1 dash in the bracket. O1 dash will be not visible. Along with that B dash will be visible when the observer views from here. B and D is along the same line. D won't be visible, so you will write it in the bracket as D dash. And here the corner you have C. So when the observer views from here, C will be visible, so you will write it as C dash. And the top center O will be visible when it is viewed from the front. So you will write this as O dash. And you have to show the dimension of the axis as exactly equal to 60 mm. Don't forget to write as XY line, VP and HP in every problem. So once you complete the first stage, we have to see what is the inclination of axis in the second stage. So here the axis of the pyramid is inclined to HP at 40 degree. So you leave some space and then take After taking 40 degree line, please show the angle. It is 40. So now we have to shift the axis which was vertical in the first stage to 40 degree line. So the entire front view which was erect will be now shifted to 40 degree line. For that, first you should identify the distance from the center to the corner C dash, how much it is, using the compass. And just move on this axis line until the distance cuts exactly on XY line. So where it cuts, you just make an arc. So from this point to this, this distance is exactly equal to this point which is cutting on XY line. So once you do, make a reference point, you just join from the reference point to the arc what you have cut. So you got the half edge. So remaining half edge of the bottom surface, you need to get it. For that you will just extend the line what you have constructed. So it should be exactly 90 degree to the axis line. And again from the center to the corner A dash, how much it is you measure. Come here and just cut an arc. So we got the full base. After that both will be equal almost. Then you will measure the 60 mm. What is the distance of the axis? 60 mm. Come here and just cut an arc. So we got O dash, right? So now you will join both the corners from here to here and from here to here. So you have the names here. So please you write the same naming. So this is A dash. So this is C dash. And here you have B dash, D dash and O1 dash, B dash is outside the bracket, D1 dash is within the bracket, O1 dash is within the bracket. So once we have shifted the axis which was perpendicular to 40 degree to HP, now it's our duty to take the projection down. So please take the projection from C dash, O1 dash, A1 dash and O dash. Once you take the projection, kindly extend the projection from our top view also. After doing, kindly erase the extra lines. Then start reading the locus. So locus of A is meeting A dash at this point. So this is our A. So locus of B is meeting B dash at this point. So this is our B. Locus of D is meeting D dash at this point. This is our D. Locus of C is meeting C dash at this point. This is our C. Locus of O is meeting O1. Locus of bottom surface. No, it is O1. Locus of O1 is meeting O1 dash at this point. So this is our O1. Locus of O is meeting O dash at this point. So this is our O dash. The bottom surface always it is O1. And the top surface it is O. Right, and always I told you, irrespective of the problem, the outer boundary will be visible. So here the given pyramid, the axis was considered to be vertical. Now the axis is considered to be inclined. So when it is viewed from the top, the outer boundary, the edges will be visible. Right, so what we do is, we will join the outer boundary. So outer boundary, A to B will be visible. B to O will be visible, D to O will be visible, D to A will be visible, right? And always if you have a corner lying on XY line, the projection passing through that corner will be hidden. So from C you have two projections coming in the base edge. So C to B will be hidden and C to D will be hidden, right? So along with that, you have one more projection which is passing through inside the surface, which is it. D to O is joined. C to O also please darken. B to O also you please darken. And you have the axis O1 to O. So that is being overlapped with this longer edge. So you won't show the axis line here. Okay. And you have one more edge which is passing through inside the surface from A to O. So that part will be an line, continuous line. So just join it. So this will be the second stage, front view and the top view. So it is a problem on axis where axis is directly inclined to HP and BP. It is not appears to be, and hence it is an apparent angle problem. If it is resting on one of its side, then the true length remains the same. If it is true, the axis is inclined to BP and that too directly, not mentioning appears to be, then you have to determine the apparent angle. Right, for that first we have to take 30 degree to BP. So please take 30 degree to VP. Always, whenever it is a problem on the axis, you have to measure the true length of the axis from the first stage. So fix one point over here and name this as O. So now you measure from O to O1. What is the distance? It provides you the true length. Measure this distance and just cut an arc on this 30 degree line. So this is our O1. So draw the locus and then come to the second stage. Measure from O to O1 how much it is. It provides us the apparent length. Okay, using this distance, come here and cut an arc. Then join this. So this is our O1. So this is the true length and this is the apparent length. So if you extend this line to our XY line, we will get the angle beta. So once we got the apparent length, now we have to shift the entire top view to the apparent angle beta. we have this apparent length already. We need the remaining part to construct the bottom surface. So you just extend this apparent length of the axis and measure from O1 to A what is the distance, and you just cut an arc, right? And then from O1 to C what is the distance you measured, and you just cut an arc. So you got A and C. You need to get D and B. So from the center you need to draw a perpendicular line. So this is the center. From the center please draw a perpendicular line. So this is the perpendicular line what you have already. So from that, this is the locus of O1. So this will be exactly perpendicular to your apparent length. No, that is inclined. So what you have to do, just draw a perpendicular line. Okay, this should be 90. So once you draw a perpendicular line, please measure from O1 to B what is the distance. Come here and cut an arc. Similarly, from O1 to D what is the distance. Come here and cut an arc. So you will get the corner D and B. So once you get the corner D and B, you got the base surface. So you will join A to B and you will join A to D. So from D to C it is hidden line, and B to C also it is hidden line. So join hidden line directly instead of drawing continuous line and then changing. Kindly see and project it accordingly. Right, so this is done. So then we have the projection B to O. So kindly join B to O. It is continuous line, so draw it. So again from D to O we have. So this is D and this is O. So we completed, right? So we have shifted the top view from the second stage to that of the third stage. So see that you have taken the projection from all the ends. So from A to O also we have joined. So from O1 to O we have the axis line, but that has been overlapped by the longer edge, and hence you will show how it looks in the second stage similarly to the third stage. So once our top view of the third stage is done, we have to take the projections above. So please take the projections from D, A, C, B, O, right? After that, please extend the projection from O dash, A dash, O1 dash. Kindly erase extra lines. Start reading the locus. So this is O. Okay. Start reading the locus. Locus of D. So this is locus of D. It is meeting D1 dash at this point. So this is our D dash, not D1 dash, D dash. And locus of A. Locus of A is meeting A dash at this point. So this is our A dash. And locus of B is meeting B dash at this point. So this is our B dash. And locus of C is meeting. So this is C. And C dash is meeting here. So this is our C dash. Along with this, the center. We haven't taken the projection from the center, O1. So take the projection from O1. So the projection of O1 is meeting O1 dash at this point. So this is our O1 dash. Along with that, we have the apex A, O here. The projection of O is meeting O dash at this point. So this is our O dash. Okay. So then, now the outer boundary will be always visible. So you will join D dash to C dash, C dash to B dash, D dash to A dash, right? And B dash to O dash and A dash to O dash, the outer boundary. And one more thing is, so in the observer views from here, the bottom surface will be visible continuously. So you will join the bottom surface here. So this will be visible. So the outer surface which has been viewed will be visible, the bottom surface, and the projection coming through the bottom surface will be visible and continuous. We have done. Apart from that, we have two more projections which is coming through inside the surface, D dash to O dash and C dash to O dash. So that will be hidden. So you show hidden line from D dash to O dash, and again hidden line from C dash to O dash. Along with that, now we have the axis which is passing through O1 dash to O dash. It will be visible. So show the axis line. Okay. So this is how the final stage of the front view looks like. So in the last problem, we solved how to solve the given square pyramid when it is resting on one of its edge. So this is the problem which focus when the given problem is resting on one of its corner and axis is inclined directly to HP and VP. Since axis is directly inclined and it is not appears to be, we have to determine the apparent angle. If it was mentioned the axis of the pyramid appears to be inclined to VP, then no beta angle. Since it is directly inclined, we have to determine the beta angle and show the value of which is how much within a box. And if in case the corner which is resting on HP, the same corner if it was been inclined to VP at 30 degree, then also we won't determine the apparent angle because the sides or the edges true length remains the same. So this is the problem on axis inclination directly with respect to VP and HP. Thank you.